When working as a developer, no matter if you're working in web development, mobile app development, or any other kind of development, you're constantly facing new technologies, new frameworks, new libraries, new versions of existing frameworks and libraries. Not just when working with JavaScript and in web development, though there we definitely have lots of new stuff going on all the time. But in general, as a developer, you're constantly facing new stuff. New stuff to learn, you could say, therefore, because even if you don't learn a new programming language every year, because why would you? Even if you don't do that, you still have some new package you suddenly might need to use, or some new version where you need to get into the breaking changes and understand them and adjust your code. So there's always something to do. Oh, and of course, even if you're not learning some new technology, you still learn to write better code with the existing technologies. You still learn and improve to write better code, to use best practices, new best practices which might have emerged, to learn new patterns, and so on. So learning never stops as a developer. And for me personally, that's one of the things I like the most about writing code and about being a programmer, being a developer, because I really like learning new stuff. Now, of course, I'm also in a position where it benefits me in two ways, actually, because I do like learning new stuff, and at the same time, of course, since I create learning materials, I often can create new videos or courses or articles based on the things I learned, though I will say I'm diving into way more packages, languages, and so on than I'm creating content on, because, as mentioned, I really like that aspect. Now, of course, if you're employed at a company, if you're working on some long-term projects, you don't switch technologies all the time. Indeed, you might be working with legacy technologies a decent amount of time. I'm totally aware of that. So it is, of course, a luxury I have that I can constantly learn new stuff, though, of course, I also have my base tech stack, the base technologies I know best and I use for my internal projects, side projects, or any other client projects or anything like that. Of course, everybody has that, I guess, but being open-minded about new technologies is sometimes not just important. My main point is that it can also be fun because challenging your brain to learn new stuff, well, that's the fun part about being a human, I'd say. It's not exclusive to writing code and being a developer. At least for me, I would essentially fall asleep if I had to work with exactly the same technologies, if I had to do the same things over and over again every day. And don't get me wrong, I have lots of routines. I have lots of repetitive stuff. When I'm creating a course, there's lots of steps involved. There are many steps involved that are not that challenging or interesting. So it's not everything new every day for me as well, but it is important, at least in my opinion, to keep that interest in new things and to also reserve some time every week, at least every month, in my opinion, to dive into new technologies. At least that's what I try to do. Even if I know that a certain technology, a certain language, whatever, that I won't create a course on it, that I won't earn any money off it, even if I know that, I still try to explore new packages, new things, at least once every month, typically at least once every week. So I'm not talking about a whole day necessarily every week, but Friday afternoon, for example, is a great place in the week, at least for me, to learn new things because The week slowly fades out. On most Fridays, I don't have anything urgent to finish. Of course, that might be different for you. Then other places in the week might be better. But for me, Friday afternoon is a great spot to dive into something new. And if it's just reading the docs, even if it's just that, it is something new and I enjoy that process. And more often than not, I stumble across something, some library, let's say, which I then try out and which I then might incorporate into some future project or on which I even might create a course if I'm really excited about it. At some point, of course, I have to learn it first, obviously. But my main point is that I understand that it can also be annoying and frustrating that everything changes all the time, that we have new frameworks, new packages, new versions all the time. And it can definitely feel overwhelming that we have all these changes because you can feel like you need to learn it all and it's way too much to learn it all because you also have a job. I get that. But I've said it before and I'll say it again. You don't need to learn everything. Of course not. It's just about learning something new from time to time because that can then indeed be really fun and also make you a better developer because by learning new stuff, you challenge yourself, you keep your mind open. That's important too, I guess. And at least for me, and I would guess for many other people as well, it also makes up a significant part of the fun in my work. If you would force me to just use the same technologies every day, even if I could create lots of content off that, it would not be the same amount of fun as it is when I can also use new things from time to time. Now, as mentioned, you of course need to be able to put some time aside for these new technologies. And I'm not talking about taking your weekends to hustle on side projects and learn new stuff. You will read things like that on the internet and you absolutely don't need to do that. Relaxing and walking away from the work and also walking away from development in general is super important, at least for me. But you can probably squeeze in some time slots here and there during the week to dive into new things and to challenge yourself. And I would recommend doing that. And most importantly, I would recommend relaxing regarding all the new things you could learn. It's not about learning everything. It's just about learning something here and there, in my opinion. Though, that is, of course, just my opinion. As always, I am interested in your opinion as well. How about you? Do you like learning new things? Are you excited if there is some new library you stumbled across which you're now exploring? Or do you rather work with the same technologies, call it a day at the end of the week and not explore new stuff? Which is of course fine as well. It's just my opinion. But please let me know yours.